is sponsored by Easy Excel. VBA and Macros, Chapter 5, the Every Other Loop. Okay, so we've been talking about loops in the book, and I want to show you something cool here. Usually, we loop to look at every single row. So, for, you know, I equals 2 to final row is something that we want to do. But let's say that we want to apply green bar formatting the old way, not using table functionality. I know the table functionality adds green bar formatting. I just want to do it the old way. And so I want to go through and look at every other row, row 2, row 4, row 6, row 8. And an easy way to do that, we're going to switch over to VBA here and take a look at the code. So first thing we do, first line of code in every macro that I write is figure out where the last row is today. Final row equals cells rows.count and XL up, and figure out what row that is. And then here's the regular loop for I equals 2 to final row. Each time through the loop, we're going to go to row number I and change the color index to 35. This underscore here is a continuation character. Actually, it's a space and an underscore is a continuation character. I did that to make it fit here in the size of the iPod window. Okay, now this would go through and color every single row, but what I want to do is I want to have it color every other row. So we're going to add a new bit to this for next loop here. It's called step. All right, so step 2 would go through and color every other row. Now let's try this. Let's do step 3 and see if we can color every third row. All right, and I'm actually going to run this slowly. So I press the F8 key, and we'll hover over final row. We see that there's 145 rows in the data set today. We're going to go from 2 to 145. So the first time through, when I hover over I, you see that we're about to format row 2. I'll run that line of code, and we'll switch back to Excel and see that it happened. All right, so right there, we've applied some green formatting to row 2. But now, when we do next I, it jumped. It jumped by a factor of 3. So instead of being 2, now I is equal to 5. You see that we colored that line of code. All right, and this is just going to keep going through. We'll run it a few more times, and you'll see that we're coloring more and more lines of code. I'll just let it run now, run the rest of the way through now that I see that it's working. And you see that we've colored the third line every time. So a great variation on the for next loop is being able to step, not and look at every number, but every second number or third number or fourth number, or if you're looking at weeks, every seventh row, or, you know, the possibilities are endless. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.